Hello guys, in this video, we will compare the generated images from the paid Midjourney and the freely available alternative, which is based on Stable Diffusion. I have selected 10 different type images that are generated by Midjourney, and each image will be like a test round. The alternative generators can be found on this site. The link is in the description of the video. There are a large number of models to choose from, and there is also an illustrative image to give you an idea of what to expect from each model. Once you have chosen the model you want to use, just click here to choose either the light, stable, or nightly version. We will choose this first model today because, according to my experience, it can achieve the best results, and we will launch the stable version. This is where we connect to the runtime and run the code. After about 5 minutes, when all necessary packages are loaded, a link will be displayed. As soon as we click on it, a new window will open with a graphical interface called Web UI, which is based on Gradio UI. Here we will write prompts that we will copy from prompthunter.com for today's purposes. On this website, you can get an idea of how to build your prompt. Since we will be comparing whether free alternatives can generate as satisfactory results as Midjourney, we will copy the image prompts generated in Midjourney to make the same request to the free generator. Since we all love cars, I chose an image of a super sports car for the first round of generation. So I copy his prompt, which I insert into Web UI. Before I start the generation, I turn on the high resolution fix here and add the number of sampling steps, because otherwise the results will be very poor. So here we see that the result is quite decent, but we'll try again. Yeah, I really like the result. I think Stable Diffusion held its own this round. I chose this stylized photo as another example. We'll see how Stable Diffusion deals with that. It doesn't look completely bad, but there are bugs. We'll give it a second try. Again, I think Stable Diffusion did very well in the second round. For the third round of generation, I chose this image of a tree beard. So this result is quite far from the original image we saw. We'll give it a second chance. And even on the second try, the result is not even a bit similar. So in this case, Stable Diffusion failed. Stable Diffusion will have another chance to succeed in the fourth round. I chose a Disney-style character, so we'll see. Although it is not at all similar, but in the prompt it is stated that the character should be a superhero characterizing the immune system. The result is not bad. My opinion is that the Stable Diffusion produced a nice image, but the Midjourney handled it somewhat better. What do you think? Let me know in the comments. I also see a lot that Midjourney is widely used to generate illustrations for graphic interfaces for various websites or applications. That's why I chose this mobile graphics UI as another example. Again, I think the result is good, but why not try again? Yes, Stable Diffusion scores again for me. In the next round, we will try to deal with such a logo. It doesn't look complicated. I think it should be okay. Oh, so he must have messed up on what the letter R looks like. Well, we have to give it another chance. Wrong again this round. The free generator didn't perform at all. Next up is this sci-fi scene. So again, Stable Diffusion missed. I wouldn't give a point for Stable Diffusion this round. How about something like this? It wasn't a problem, but I wouldn't be me if I didn't give it another try. I think Stable Diffusion did a very good job again. I would try something more realistic. For this round, I chose this image of a living room. It's not bad at all, but the cat seems to have grown a rather long tail. I wonder how long it will be on the next try. The anatomy of the cat looks a bit better, and overall the picture is very good. Another point for Stable Diffusion. I would call the last round as a rest. An image in this style should perhaps not be a problem. And it wasn't either. It's not exactly the same, but it sticks to the prompt and it's quite nice. To sum up, considering that the freely available model generated images that were very similar to the results from Midjourney for most of the examples, I can only say that this particular model is comparable to the Midjourney, but mainly Web UI offers private link, where you can generate anything you can think of without limits. What do you think, and what do you use? Midjourney or Stable Diffusion? I would love to read your opinion, so let me know in the comments section. If you liked the video, please let me know with a like. And don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notifications so you don't miss anything.